Hello, everybody. Can you hear me? No. Thank you. Can you hear me? So, hello. I am Sophie Bréjean from Éphémère. I will talk about the Replication Manager. So, first, I will introduce. Dick talked about the Replication Manager before. I will just introduce it and speak of some vocabulary. What are the Replication Manager roles? And then we will see more in details the ingestion process and the restricted data special case. And then I will show you some information about the installation and configuration. So, as Dick said, the Replication Manager will replace the Download Manager in each data center. And it will be installed as a part of the CDataNet infrastructure. So, the Replication Manager handles all the communication between data center and Maris and UDAT. This is the infrastructure evolution. And what we see that UDAT is a new element. So this is how it works now with the Download Manager. There is only Maris, the data center, and the CDataNet users. And the new step is the UDAT Cloud. The new element is the UDAT Cloud. So now you have the data center, Maris, and UDAT, and the CDataNet users. So a little vocabulary. Data center, you all know what is a data center, I think. So the Download Manager will be replaced by the Replication Manager. On Maris side, the Import Manager we will use for the ingestion of metadata and data. The CDI portal and the RSM are still there. The cloud, so as Arsha said, there will be 5 UDAT centers. Each data center is connected on only one cloud, UDAT center, depending on the geography. So this is the global CDataNet infrastructure. And just one more word, batch, because I will speak of batches. It's just a set of local CDI IDs, so metadata and data. So what are the roles of the Replication Manager? One of the main roles is metadata and data ingestion. So it's a process by which the records will be added or updated in the infrastructure. So we can see the mouse. So this is the data center. You will provide the metadata as today and the data. The metadata will be uploaded to Maris as today, and the data will be uploaded to the cloud, the unrestricted data only. The restricted data will remains in the data center. For the restricted data user request, the user here will use the CDI portal. And Maris will connect to the data center to ask for restricted data. We'll see more in details after. And about the restricted data, they are stored in the data center and in multiple versions, as unrestricted data are stored in multiple versions in the UDAT cloud. So the roles, the same roles as today with the download manager. That means the replication manager will check the coupling table locally and against the CDI portal. Locally updates the BODC vocabularies. What is new is that the replication manager will provide an administration dashboard, will check the CDI metadata files and check the data files before uploading. Now, more in details, the ingestion process has four steps. First is the local manual preparation. This is step zero. Step one is submission. Step two is local preparation by the replication manager. Sorry. Yes. And step three is ingestion in the infrastructure. We will see each step in details now. So the first step is local manual preparation. It's just as today with the download manager, you will have to create the CDI metadata files using Mikado, create the data files using Nemo, Octopus, or other. Organize data in directories or in database, depending what you want to use. You have to create the coupling table in a database or in a file. Create the mapping files if you are using Modus 2. So this is exactly the same as today with the download manager. If everything is ready today with the download manager, there is no need to change anything for the replication manager. Next step is the submission. So you will have to put the CDI's metadata zip files in a special directory dedicated for that and triggers the ingestion process using the dashboard. This is a little screenshot, the beta version. Once you have put the zip files in this dedicated directory, you will see them in the dashboard, and then you have a submit button to trigger the ingestion. That means that the replication manager will call the Maris import manager and start the ingestion. The next step just before calling Maris is preparing data. So all the selected CDI's metadata will be read. We will read your local CDI IDs, restriction policies, and available formats, so that replication manager will create all data in all given formats in the CDIs, and check the CDIs and check the data. Then the replication manager will move metadata and data in a queue, and then call Maris. This is a part of the page where when you will follow all the workflow of each batch. So here, for example, you can see that globally the batch is in queue, ready. The CDI status, which means the metadata, is check ready, and the data status is in queue, so waiting for the next step. Next step is to upload first to connect to Maris and then to start the ingestion. This is done by the batch sender every 15 seconds. He reads all the batches that are ready in the queue and then take the first one and start in the ingestion. Ingestion is done on one batch at a time. This is what you can see here, the current batch, ingestion pending. CDI in metadata are in harvest zone, and data status is in queue zone. So that means here the ingestion is starting. The replication manager has called Maris to say, I have a batch to send to you. So we can start. The metadata are in harvest zone, where Maris will be able to download it. Next step is the whole ingestion. So there is some exchanges between the replication manager, Maris, and UDAT. Maris has a central role, playing the conductor role, and in the ingestion, maybe we need some manual actions. So at some moments, you will see in the dashboard that human interactions are needed, and you will have to connect in Maris dashboard and take some decisions. So one batch at a time, the replication manager moves the CDI batches in the harvest directory, calls the import manager to inform that the batch is ready. The import manager harvests this metadata, checks the metadata, and if everything is okay, the import manager calls the replication manager and asks for him to upload unrestricted data on the cloud. Then the import manager will check the unrestricted data on the cloud and send to the replication manager the version numbers. Everything is automatic. You will have only to follow this on the dashboard, but there is no human actions. This is the first part of the exchange. Application manager has a batch which is ready. Call the import manager. You can harvest this batch. Import manager will harvest it and eventually say that there is some human action needed. When everything is okay, the import manager calls replication manager to upload the data files. Replication manager upload data files on the cloud and informs the import manager. Eventually, other human actions here. And at the end, the import manager will set the versions to the replication manager and send the last call to say that the process is ended for this batch. Then we start the next batch. Now, one word for the restricted data special case. So, as for unrestricted data, the CDI metadata files are sent to the import manager. The restricted data files are generated or converted, or depends on what modus you use. Restricted data will be checked locally. And this is special for restricted data. They are stored in the data center. They are not uploaded to the cloud. That means that maybe the data center will assure the data center will need some more disk space that was what is needed now with the download manager. This is the difference for the user orders. For unrestricted data, user orders are made on the for all data. User orders are made on Maris portal, and the data are stored on the cloud on UDAT. So there is no need on the data center for the unrestricted data for the user orders. But for restricted data, the RSM will call the replication manager for restricted data. The replication will prepare a zip, upload it to the UDAT cloud, just for temporarily. What's next? Sorry. So the replication manager will upload restricted data on the cloud, where the user can find it. And at the end, the restricted data will be deleted from the cloud. This is just for the order. About installation, Replication Manager is, I hope, easy to install, more easy than Download Manager. It's just one web application. There is two parts, RM API, with the interfaces with Import Manager and RSM and UDAT Cloud. API is used for the ingestion process and the order process for restricted data. The other part is the Replication Manager dashboard for configuration, for checks, log access, maintenance, and the ingestion workflow. Just a web application, that means no more batches and no more complicated installation. So the requirements is a Tomcat server and Java. The batches history, all the workflow is stored in an embedded database, so you don't need to install a database. So that just put a WAR file into the Tomcat web apps directory. For the configuration, the organization and the installation of data, coupling table, etc. is exactly the same that for the Download Manager, so you don't have to change anything. Configuration is quite simple. You just have to choose directories because you have seen there is a queue where the zip will be waiting in some kind of directories. So you just have to choose where you want to put your zip and fill the configuration file. This is a summary of the tree that you will need. All paths are independent, so you can choose where ready to send directory is where you will put the new CDI to submit. You will need a temporary directory to create the data files and a queue directory and archives to store the restricted data. You will need some configuration files, unit translation, etc. as today for the Download Manager. And on the bottom, the data, the mapping files, and the coupling, just as today for the Download Manager. Then you can check the installation in the dashboard. I think this is the dashboard. You can see some maintenance items. Configuration, you can see rapidly if the configuration is valid or not. You have all the parameters below. The page is bigger than that. But, so this is what you can see in the web page, what you wrote in the configuration file. So you can fix or change the configuration file, click on the reload button and just upload the configuration. You don't need to restart the server. I think it's quite easy. For the maintenance, you see that you can see the log files in the web page, launch the BUDC updates, launch the Replication Manager checker. And that's I'm not sure if you can read something. Here we have the links to the log files. The BODC vocabularies, you can see what versions of each list. And information about the embedded database. And just one word about the virtual appliance. As for the download manager, there will be a virtual appliance available for the replication manager to be more easy to install. You can find virtual appliance for download manager here, and it's not ready for the replication manager, but will be soon. So the aim is to install only this virtual machine, deploy the machine, and just modify the replication manager configuration files. So you can choose if you prefer to install your own Tomcat server and replication manager, or use a virtual appliance. Any questions?